So these are the graphs of the parabola given that the vertex is at 0, 0. Okay, so this is the figure of a parabola which opens upward, opens downward, opens to the right, and opens to the left. And lahat na parabola ay merong vertex, focus, axis of symmetry, directrix, of course, the parabola itself, and we have also this line, what we call the latus rectum. So, we have here the table for the graphs of the parabola if the given vertex is in 0, 0 or at the origin. And for the first two standard equations, y squared is equal to 4cx and y squared is equal to negative 4cx. Okay, so we have the first variable, which is y, and naka-raised siya sa 2. Okay, so the other parts of the equation, yung isa positive at yung isa ay negative. Okay, kapag ganito ang forma ng equation natin, we expect that the graph opens to the right, okay, if the given is positive, and opens to the left naman kapag ang given natin dun sa right side ng equation is negative. Okay, so we expect also that the axis of symmetry is still the same in x-axis. Okay, so magkaiba lang ng direction. It is either to the left or to the right. Okay, and then for the last two set of equation, or to the last two equations, standard form of equation, we have x squared is equal to 4cy, and x squared is equal to negative 4cy. Different signs, of course, we are expecting different direction of the graph. Kapag ang given naman natin is x squared, do sa left equation, okay, so we expect ang graph natin, it is either upward or downward. Okay, so ang magiging indicator lang natin kung upward or downward, depende dun sa ating sign. Okay, kung positive, therefore, we have a graph opens upward, and of course, if it is negative, it opens downward. Okay, so this set of equation has an axis of symmetry, which is nasa y-axis. Example number 1. Let us graph x squared is equal to 8y. So, this equation follows, kung titignan ninyo doon sa table na ginawa natin, this equation follows, so kung titignan natin yung table doon sa standard form na ipinascreenshot ninyo, na ipinascreenshot ko, ang equation na parehas doon sa ating given is nakaporma ng x squared equals 4cy. Okay? So, parehas sila ng variable na x squared. Ay, ulit. Let us graph x squared equals 8y. Okay, this equation follows. Okay, pakitingnan doon sa table na ibinigay ko kanina kung anong forma ng standard form ang parehas doon sa ating given na x squared equals 8y. Okay, so kung bang makikita ninyo na yun ay parehas sa x squared equals 4cy, wherein the left side of the equation has a term x squared, and then the other term is nakalagay sa right side having a variable y. Okay, so kapag nag-graph tayo, kailangan makuha natin yung focal distance. Okay, and then to get the focal distance, we are going to use the okay, so we will use the equation wherein yung C yung ating focal distance. So to get C, okay, so we all know that x squared is equal to x squared. Okay, equal yan. So, ibig sabihin yung 4cy ay equal kay 8y. So, we are going to equate 4cy is equal to 8y. Okay, so it is and then to get the focal distance, divide both sides of the equation, wherein c na lang matitira dito, and para c na lang matitira dito, divide both sides by 4y. 4y. Okay, so which leads to 4cy divided by 4y, cancel si 4, and then cancel si y, ang matitira dito is yung c, is equal to 8y divided by 4y, cancel si y, so 8 divided by 4, that is 2. So, therefore, the focal distance is 2 units. Okay, we have 2 units. So, kung i-graph natin, ito yung ating vertex. And then, since ang given natin ay naka x squared equals 4cy, this equation opens upward. Okay, this equation opens upward. So, if it is opens upward, bilang tayo ng 2 units upward, so we have 1 and 2. So, this point now is the focus. And again, this is the vertex. Okay, so next, the vertex is obviously 0, 0. And then, the focus, okay, kunin natin yung coordinate ng focus. So, ang focus natin dito is, we have 0, 2. Okay, kunin natin yung coordinate ng focus, that is 0, 2. And then, the axis of symmetry, when we say axis of symmetry, ito yung line yung naghahati sa parabola, but in axis of symmetry, nandun yung ating vertex and nandun din yung ating focus. And based sa figure natin, yung focus and vertex is on y-axis. Okay, nasa y-axis. And then the directrix. Again, the directrix, kung ito ay 2 units, therefore, bilang din tayo, pababa naman mula sa vertex ng 2 units. So, nung nagbilang tayo 1 and 2, so, andito yung point natin kay directrix, and gawa tayo ng line gamit yung point na yan na perpendicular sa axis of symmetry. So, this is the line of the directrix. And the equation for the line of directrix is, yung point natin ay nasa y-axis, and yung point natin ay nasa negative 2 ng y-axis. So, therefore, this directrix is y is equal to negative 2. And then, we have also the latus rectum. Okay, to get the latus rectum, that is 4c. Okay? And, sabi ko kanina din, kung ito ay 2 units, so doblehin lang natin yung part dun sa parabola. Okay? Kung ito ay 2 units, dito ay magiging 4 units. So, bilang tayo ng 4. We have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So, this is one end point of latus rectum na dadaan sa focus. And then, bilang din tayo ulit ng 4 units sa kabila. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So, this is end point of the latus rectum. So, kapag bibilangin natin, kung ito 4 units, therefore, ito rin also is 4 units. So, 4 plus 4 equals 8 units. Okay, and then, kapag kinuha na natin yung length of the latus rectum, kunin natin yung end points. Okay, kunin natin yung coordinate point ng end points natin. Okay, so, this point is negative 4, kama positive 2. Ito naman ay positive 4, kama 2. Okay? And then, to graph this, okay, meron na tayong end point, may vertex na rin tayo. Ay, meron na rin tayong focus at directrix. Latus rectum meron din. Let us now connect the vertex and the endpoints of the latus rectum. So, ganito magiging itsura niya. Hindi siya pa V-shape, siya ay U-shape. Okay? So, this is now the graph. Pangalanan natin, ang pangalan ng graph nito is x squared is equal to 8y. And then, this graph now is the final answer. Example number 2. Graph y squared equals negative 12x. So, this equation follows. Kung titingnan natin dun sa ating table, siya ay parehas doon sa y squared equals sa negative 4cx. So, therefore, this equation follows y is equal to negative 4cx. Okay, and then, let us identify the focal distance. And to solve the focal distance, again, we are going to equate the terms here. So, again, y squared ay pareha sa y squared. So, therefore, i-equate natin ang negative 4cx sa negative 12x. So, we have negative 4cx is equal to negative 12x. And to get the value of c as the focal distance, divided both sides by negative 4x. Negative 4x. Then, cancel si negative sign. Si 4 cancel as well as x. So, matitira dito is c. C is equal to, cancel dito si x. And then, si x. And then, negative 12x divided by negative 4x is equal to positive 3. So, therefore, the focal distance is 3 units. Okay, and then, let us identify the vertex. Of course, kapag ganito klaseng equation, ang given natin, the vertex is always 0, 0. And then, the focus. Okay, so, to identify the focus, okay, let us draw, or let us plot first the vertex, which is 0, 0. And then, bilang tayo ng 3 units. Okay, 3 units. Sa upward, downward, right, or to the left. Okay, based sa given natin kanina, okay, dapat ay opening to the left. So, magbibilang tayo ngayon ng 3 units to the left. Mula sa point natin na ito, we have 1, 2, and 3. So, this would be our focus. And get the coordinates of the focus. So, we have negative 3, 0. So, negative 3, 0 as the focus. And the axis of symmetry. Okay, titingnan natin yung line kung nasaan yung vertex pati yung focus. And as you can see, the axis of symmetry is on x-axis. And then the directrix. Okay, so bilang naman tayo sa kabila ng 3 units mula sa ating vertex. So, we have 1, 2, and 3. So, this is the point of the directrix. And draw a line perpendicular sa ating axis of symmetry, which is also parallel naman sa ating y-axis. So, this is the directrix. And the equation for the directrix is, since yung point natin ay nasa x-axis, so we have to write x is equal to, asaan yung point natin sa x-axis? Nasa 3. So, x is equal to 3. Okay, and then the length of the latus rectum. So, mula sa ating focal distance, so, the length of the latus rectum mula sa ating focus na negative 3, 0, bibilang tayo ng dalawang 3 units mula sa focus. Kasi sabi ko nga, dodoblehin natin yung focal distance para makuha ang endpoint ng isang latus rectum. And then, ganun din gagawin natin sa kabila. So, bilang tayo ng dalawang 3 units. So, therefore, 6 units. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, this is our one point for, or this is the end point of the latus rectum. And then, ganun din sa kabila. Okay, and then, ang coordinate point nito is nasa negative 3. Okay, ito tatapat sa x-axis. And then, sa y-axis, nasa positive 6. Okay, and then, ganun din dito. We have negative 3, negative 6. Okay, itong point natin na to. So, the length of the latus rectum, if we have 6 here and then another 6 here, so we have 12 units. Okay? So, and then the end points of the latus rectum, as I mentioned, okay, ito yon and ito. Okay, so to graph now the y squared equals negative 12x, we are going to connect the one end point of the latus rectum to the vertex. And then, from the vertex, drawing din ulit tayo ng another one na magko-connect sa ating parabola. So, this graph, ilalagay natin ang pangalan y is equal to negative 12x. Okay, and then this graph now is the final answer. Okay, to get an additional information dun sa ating parabola. Okay, kapag kukuha tayo ng points dito sa parabolang ito, again, yung distance ng point na to hanggang doon sa ating focus, okay, is the same with the distance doon sa point hanggang sa point ng directrix forming 90 degrees. So, for example, if it is 3 units, therefore, it is also 3 units. Halimbawa lang yon. Okay, another one, another point naman na kukunin natin. Halimbawa, itong point na to, yung distance nito ay palaging pareha sa distance nito perpendicular sa ating directrix. Okay, isa pa. So, isa ulit, pag ito yung point natin, okay, pag kinuha natin distance ng point natin hanggang dito sa ating focus, ganun din ang may distance ng from point natin ng parabola hanggang dun sa point ng directrix perpendicular dun sa ating line. So, laging ganun ang ating parabola. Find the equation of the parabola with the vertex at 0, 0 and the focus at 0, -1/2. Before giving the equation of the parabola, okay, let us observe the given. The vertex is at 0, 0. Okay, so this is our vertex, 0, 0, and the focus at 0, -1/2. Kapag ganito ang focus natin, yung point natin ay nasa y-axis pababa ng vertex. Okay, so probably dito talaga yung ating focus. So, ito yung vertex and then ito yung ating focus. Okay, so for us to know kung anong direction ang gagamitin natin para kay parabola, titingnan natin yung direction ng point natin kay focus with respect dun sa position ni vertex. Kung ang focus natin ay nasa baba ng vertex, therefore yung graph natin opens downward. Okay? Halimbawa naman, kung ang focus natin ay nasa right side ng equation, halimbawa kung nandito yung focus natin, therefore yung graph natin opens downward. Okay, as well as kung ang focus natin ay nasa taas ng vertex, we expect naman yung graph natin opens upward. But this time, ang given natin, ang focus ay nasa baba ng vertex, therefore the graph opens downward. Okay, so if the graph opens downward, okay, the equation that we are going to use is, okay, so we are going to use x is equal to -4cy. Okay, we are going to use negative, it is because yung graph natin is downward. Okay, so itong equation ang gagamitin natin and we are looking for the focal distance para makuha natin yung equation. Okay, so hindi naman pwede na ganito equation natin kasi kulang ng focal distance. Para makuha ang focal distance is titingnan natin sa graph muna. Okay, sa graph, mapapansin ninyo na ang distance ng vertex dun sa ating focus ay 1/2. So, yung point na to hanggang dito, that is 1/2. So, we will say that C is equal to 1/2. Okay, so please be reminded that C is always positive. Okay, kasi wala tayong negative na distance. Okay, so we will have x squared is equal to -4cy. And then x squared is equal to -4 times ang distance natin, that is 1/2. Okay, and then y. So, x squared is equal to -4 times 1/2, that is -2y. Okay, so this is now the final answer. Okay, halimbawa naman. Halimbawa, kukunin naman natin yung distance. In such a way na hindi natin titingnan sa graph. Okay, para makuha yung focal distance, we are going to use the distance formula. Okay, between two points, ang points natin is 0, 0 and okay, 0, -1/2. So, distance is equal to quantity x(2 - x)1 squared plus y(2 - y)1 squared. So, it is equal to x(2 - x)1, that is 0 - 0. We have 0 - 0 and then squared plus y(2), that is 0 - -1/2. and then squared, and then it is equal to square root of 0 plus 0 plus 1 half, that is 1 fourth. Okay, 1 half squared. 0 plus 1 fourth equals 1 fourth. And then square root of 1, that is square root of 1 over 4, can be written as square root of 1 all over square root of 4. And then square root of 1, that is 1. And the square root of 4, that is 2. So, the focal distance is 1 half. Okay, kung hindi natin i-graph. So, kapag nakuha na natin focal distance, pwede na natin itong gawin. So, the final answer or the equation of the parabola of this equation, okay, so the equation of the parabola of this graph is x squared is equal to negative 2y. Okay, for our activity, solve the following problems below. Okay, so for each item, you must write the equation, focal distance, vertex, focus, directrix, axis of symmetry, the length of the latus rectum, and the endpoints of the latus rectum.